This video is going to be about the relationship between the volume of a cone and a cylinder. Now, a cylinder, its volume is going to be the base times the height, and the volume of a cone is going to be 1/3 of its base times height. That's the main idea. But let's start from the beginning. Volume of a cylinder is the area of that base, that circle, times its height. So our formula is going to be pi r squared, the area of a circle, times the height of the cylinders. There's our height there. And there's our radius. We're going to do pi r squared to find that area. Well, our height for the cylinder is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. And the radius is going to be 1, 2. You can see it right there. And the radius is going to be 2. So volume is going to equal pi r squared times the height. Well, pi r squared, we're going to take our radius, which is 2, say pi times r squared, and multiply that times the 4. So we have pi times 2 squared times the height, which is 4. And so 2 squared is 4, so it's pi times 4, but we don't write it that way. We're going to write it as 4 times pi times 4, which is the height, and 4 pi times 4 is going to give you a total of 16 pi. That is the total exact volume. But if you multiply times 3.14, you're going to get an approximation of about 50.24. So let's recap. We have our radius and our height. It's 2 and 4. We find the area of the base, pi r squared, times our height. And that ends up giving us 16 pi, or about 50.24. But what if we put a little dot right there in the center and come straight down? That's going to be the height, still, of that cylinder. And the radius could be put on that bottom base down there. That's still going to be the same radius and the same height. And if we draw our line segments there, we've now created a cone. Same exact radius, same exact height, same area of the base. But here's the most important thing. Even with the same radius and same height, if they are the same, if you take away this third of your cylinder, just erase that 1/3 of that volume, if that's all taken away, and then you take away this second third of this volume, you take all that away, you're left with only 1/3 of the volume. Well, let's go ahead and show that that's true in the real world. Let's take an actual cylinder, same base on top and bottom, and a cone has the exact same size base, that same circle on the bottom. It fits on there exactly. Fell off. Exact same height. Let's see if they're going to have 1/3 of the volume. Now, volume means how much stuff can you fit inside? How many cubes can you fit inside? There's the net of the cone. And I'll quickly show you the net of the cylinder. It's made of a rectangle and two circles. That'll help when you do the surface area, but let's see if it's going to be 1/3. Let's take some rice and see how it fits in here. Let's see, it's got 1 cup. I'm going to fill that up. And let's fill up one more. And let's see if it does exactly 3. Let's fill this up. And there we go. It's 3 times the volume of that cone. Fits in there exactly. So let's get back to our formula. It's going to be 1/3. Volume is equal to pi r squared times height divided by 3. You're usually going to see it as 1/3 pi r squared times height. So with our final cone, it's going to be 16 pi divided by 3, or about 50.24 divided by 3. And when you divide that out, you're going to get approximately 16.75. So remember, you just take the area of the base times the height and divide by 3 for the volume of a cone.